What advice would you give to someone who is starting on the professional career generally, particularly to a young entrepreneur?
You see, your question is very important, vital for a young entrepreneur.
Good afternoon, Mr. Mostafa Kamal. Thank you so much for your time. Could you please tell us a bit about yourself and your family?
Thank you so much. My name is Mostafa Kamal. I born in 1955, Kumilla district. From that, I started actually my education. And I have a family, my wife, my three daughter, one son. They are graduated from UK and USA. 3 years joined with me. My younger one, she also completed her graduation. This year, she will become very soon with me. This is my small family.
What motivated you to become an entrepreneur?
Actually, after liberation, I told you I am in Kumilla district. It is actually near to the Indian border. So we are in a border. There is a liberation period. There is a food crisis. We are struggling a lot. And you know, that time in Bangladesh, 1972-71, there is no infrastructure, nothing there. So there is a number one border, and there is a war between Pakistan and Bangladesh. Yeah, after liberation, there is a, actually in border area, there is a lot of problem arises because there is no infrastructure, number one. Number two, there is a liberation period. So food crisis, there is a heavy food crisis. People are charging food, but there is no, there is only two hot bazaar in a week. But although because of the there is a communication gap, so people are actually a lot of problem they are facing. From that, there is a two bazaar. From that, I am thinking, is there anything possibility to make a trading, especially in essential item, mainly cooking oil, salt, sugar, it is in my mind. So that is when I become in Dhaka. So I am working as a small shopkeeper who are dealing oil, edible oil, sugar, salt, this thing. From that, I have in my mind, if we can import this raw material and we can process. So there are two things. It is easy to actually distribution, and there is employment generation. These two things actually seriously keeping in my mind and always reminding me if anything we can do. But you know, the business start after liberation, even for 50 years before, there is a huge problem in the business. There is a capital, you cannot go, if we go bank will not willing to give any loan or anything. Started first, my flagship business is edible oil. In the year 1989, I became a one, first industry is palm oil industry. Then, you know, because of shortage of my capital, first I process palm oil, and after that I joined the soybean oil debugging unit and other unit. So you know, this is the things how after liberation people started the business, which there is a lot of struggle and infrastructure, many things. There is nothing at that time. That is me.
Meghna Group is one of the biggest palm oil importers in Bangladesh. Could you please tell us a bit about your company and what are your main areas of business? Your company spans a variety of diverse areas. How do you generate new ideas and decide to expand into new area or dimension?
Thank you. Actually, I am one of the largest palm oil importer. Every year we are importing 300 to 400,000 ton minimum palm oil. Moreover, is Bangladesh cooking oil, you know, mainly actually almost 70% people are using cooking oil. Cooking oil mainly palm oil. There are two things. One is actually the Malaysia, Indonesia is very near to us for the freight, distance, time is little less, freight is little less. And that is why we are more focused into the palm oil, and palm oil consumer also now become every day. It is increasing because you know there is a food diversification. Bangladesh now buying capacity also people buying capacity also increasing. Industrial biscuit, noodles, and many other items. Bangladesh now in cookies, so many items now. There's a food diversification and cooking both, as well as the palm oil actually consumption is increasing. And you ask another one thing, how other business diversification? Actually, diversification, actually it is a continuation of business. You know, business, any industry, so we are always thinking to upgradation, modification, expansion. But at the same time, we are thinking and watching and following up the, what is other the gap. So what is importing mainly from Chittagong port, we are watching in the global, and mainly in Bangladesh, which item are mainly imported, big bullion. So we are watching and we are thinking in my mind, so can we do this that way? So we have now in the cement industry, with pulp and paper, chemical, so our power plant. So we have almost, we have 48 unit. So it is mainly first basic industry, and then it is backward and forward. So we have shipping also, but you know, the, because of the, my commodities importing, so we have foreign mother vessel also. Internal also, I have a shipbuilding, internal vessel also, 5,000 ton material, we have more than 100 vessel. So it is for needed, we are always continuously expanding our business, and as well as the diversification also.
How do you foresee the role of palm oil in the Bangladesh market over the next 5 to 10 years?
Look, I told you, it is not only cooking. Bangladesh, actually, cooking oil, 70% is palm oil using. I told you, by this time I mentioned you, as because it is easy, available, because it's Indonesia, Malaysia is mainly, it is very near to us, freight. And the Bangladesh is a price sensitive market. Because of palm oil, freight is less, and international market, soybean and palm oil, there is a price difference. So, and other things is now industrial use, mainly palm oil is industrial use. So Bangladesh, there is a lot of food diversification, so they are using. And another thing is buying capacity. And people, so because of this, I think it will continue increasing. Still, we are 60 to 70% palm oil importing. So I think it will continue, and if it is, manufacturing country, if they little bit more promotion in Bangladesh, I think, and awareness, so it will more helpful for us to import more. At the moment, there is every year 5 to 6% increasing palm oil importing continuously, because soybean already going to be very less with compared to 30 years, 20 years, 15 years before.
What are some ways in which palm oil use can be encouraged in the country?
I mentioned you, it is manufacturing country, can awareness and because there is a lot of palm oil is beta carotene plus other things. Already Malaysian Palm Oil Promotion Bureau, they have many seminars, symposium, and awareness. I think it is better, they know better than us how to promote it. But by the same, we are consumption is going to be increasing.
What are some of the main obstacles that you faced in your 4 decades long career, and how did you overcome these challenges?
Actually, you know, the obstruction is so much. After liberation, I told you there is no infrastructure, road, bridge, or service industry. There is no service industry, but and moreover, bureaucracy, financial capital, everything. So actually now things is changing. By the same government is also because of the demand or our business community to make them understand our bureaucrat and politician that this is the problem. If it is overcome, we can grow more. So now it's more better than area than this before. Before was, so it was a, you know, very big problem we are facing, and we overcome it. Like me, all other entrepreneurs, everybody is, they are working very hard, they are facing a lot of problem, it's unimaginable. So now a day, and before 30, 40 days, you cannot think it.
What are a few of the most important lessons for successful CEO to keep in mind?
Well, actually CEO, you know, CEO is becoming a so many step crossing the CEO. Because it is the main thing is which area, which particular item you are dealing. So you have step by step you become the CEO. So first you need the teamwork, and you understand your team and you direction your team, monitoring your team, different sector, different type of things to monitor. So the CEO can always what team he is leading. So he understands better, or he should monitor always. Actually, it is not the set menu. So we many set the menu and they start working. Whatever it is problem come, or whatever the what about the market is changing, market wants, according to the CEO have direction, his colleague or his team, and they work and always have to the information. Information is the key. It is a set word, but actually it is the reality. So take information. After information, you have to decision how you forward, because your competitor have so other things also. So many things can become a CEO have to be not like as 24 hours he will work hard, but he should monitor and he should guide the team.
In your opinion, what is the best way to achieve healthy work-life balance?
Actually, it is difficult question, depend on man to man. But my case is, you know, where we started from the very zero. I started my career is a $4-5 a month salary. So it is not from me to advise someone, because there's just many steps I overcome, so many challenges, so many problems. So always fasting, work, hard working, and honesty, sincerity, you should need it. At the same time, it is a responsibility of the family. You know, my daughter, my children, time difference, one is USA, one is elder one in London. So always without talking to them, even I am so overstressed, always without talking with them, I am not going to sleep, even almost a day. So sometimes if I'm missing, so I send a message. So earlier there is no mobile phone. So I give them a telephone in the home. So in line phone, I have to talk to them and there is a set time. So you should come in home and talk to me and then you go to sleep or university. So actually depend on the family bondage, father, my parents' responsibility, children also love to be parents. So both all together, it is a you have to make all these things to combination.
What advice would you give to someone who is starting on the professional career generally, particularly to a young entrepreneur?
You see, your question is very important, vital for young entrepreneur. But nowadays, the world economy is so very diversified, very changing. Our time and this time, it is very big difference. So one young entrepreneur, which sector he like, so then he should know previous and futures and present. This he has to study. So where, which item or which profession he go, he should study and he should have a dream. Which sector or which profession you go. This sector you have to backward, forward, present, you have to study, and you make yourself to study hard, sincerity. But there is no substitute, you have to work hard. But nowadays it is less work, it is now all intelligency. But our time we are work so many physically, but now you have to work with, there is a lot of service sector, e-commerce, so many things coming. Our time, this we cannot think. So I told one of my university, speech, I told them, our time, we are a poor family. I buy book from our elder brother. So he is promoted to the class 8 to class 9. I buy from his old book. So nowadays, you can go to internet through Harvard, MIT, Oxford. You can go and you can see. So our time, we are buying our senior people brother book and we are studying like this. So nowadays there is a lot of facility come, but you have to attract. So you yourself, you have to think how you can be forwarded yourself to make you become the entrepreneur or you become the successful, whatever it is the profession. So everybody should have think like this and aim and go forward like this.
That is all we have today. Thank you so much for your time, Mr. Mostafa Kamal.